morning students, how are you? And I think you all are doing your homeworks regularly. Yes students. Okay, now today's video is about your doubt clearing session. That means in this video I will clear your doubts. If any students having a doubt, you can mail me, okay? And in that mail you have to write your name and your class and your doubt also, okay students? And give your presentee in comment box before 9 o'clock, okay students? That means till 9 o'clock at night you are having a time for giving a presentee. After that you will be responsible for your absentee. And please write your name, full name and your division, correct division, okay students? Now see the first question. Many of the students having a doubt in exercise 1.2 first question. The question was pick the correct option. Now see, in that question there are 4 sub questions are there, and in that questions a number line is given, and on that number line some numbers and marks on that numbers are given. That means here is A, here is B, here is X, and in third one Y, and in fourth one P and Q. And we have to find which among our options, which option is correct one. Okay students, now see the first one. Number lies between A and B. That means we have to find among these 4 which number lies in between A and B. Now where is A? A and B are on the right hand side of 0. That means they are positive. So our option should be positive. Okay. If there are negative numbers, neglect that numbers, because that numbers never come in between A and B. Now so our first option will be not there, second also not there, because both are negative, and negative number never be in between A and B. Now these 2 have a chance. Okay, now see, but this third one, 0 lies before A, not in between A and B. So this option is also not there. Our correct answer is 4th one. Understand the first question, students? If your doubts are clear from this session, so write in comments your doubts are clear. Okay, students? Now see the second one. Number lies before X. Okay? So these are the numbers. 0, 1, 2, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. And here is our X. Okay students, minus 1 and minus 2, in between minus 1 and minus 2, X is there. We have to find which number lies before X. Before X means the number which comes on left hand side of X, not right hand side, okay? These numbers are after X, okay? Because this number will come first, then this number will after that, okay? That means we have to find the number which lies on the left hand side of X. Now see in the option 0, 1 by 2, both are positive. Positive number are on the left hand side or on the right hand side? They are on the right hand side. So first option is not there, second is also not there. Now see, minus 1 by 2. Minus 1 by 2 means minus 0.5. And minus 0.5 will be here. That is in between 0 and minus 1. It is also on the right hand side of X. That means that number is not before X. So third option is also not there. Only remaining one is there. That is our correct answer. That means minus 9 by 4. The value of minus 9 by 4 is minus 2.1 or something, okay? And that number will be here. That means on the left hand side of X. Understand the second question? Okay. The third one is C. Number lies after Y. That means we numerator is smaller and denominator is bigger, its answer is in 0 point something. Okay students, now see, 0 point will be here, it is before y, that means this number is not there. Now this is again the same case, numerator is smaller and denominator is bigger, so answer of this will be 0 point something, and that will be our not answer. Okay, now see the this question and this, there is remaining two, but this is a negative number and negative number is after y, no, so this option is also not correct, so only remaining is the third one, that means 48 upon 90, and the value of this will be 2 point something, okay, and that will be after y. Understand the third one? Okay, now the next, that is the last question of exercise 1.2, first questions. Number lie between P and Q. We have to find which number lies between P and Q. There are four options. We have to find which option lies in between P and Q. Now see the first option. Zero. Now see, zero lies between P and Q. Yes. This lies, but we have to check for other also. Negative number never lie here. Never lie in between P and Q because it lies on the left hand side. Now see the third one, second one. Second is, answer for this will be 4 point something. See, 5 ones are 5, 5 fours are 20. 1 will be remaining, that means 4.2. Answer of this will be 4.2. And see the numbers P and Q are only before 3, not after 3, okay? So this option is also not there. Now this one, answer for this will be 15 upon 4. Answer for this will be 3 point something. But that number is also after Y, not before 3. So this option is also not correct. So 0 is our answer. Understand the first question of exercise 1.2. If you are having any other doubt regarding this one, you can mail it, okay? And in that mail, write your name, your class. Okay, students? Understand this one? If your doubts are clear, write in comment box your name. While you are giving the presenting, write your name, your class, division, and say yes if your doubts are clear. Okay, students? Now, the next doubt, that means the next question from the second chapter. The second chapter is squares and square root. From that chapter, the student is having a doubt in exercise 2.1, question number 9. Question number 9 is, check whether the following numbers are perfect square. Question number 9 from exercise 2.1. Check whether the following numbers are perfect square. If not, find the smallest number by which this should be multiplied. This should be multiplied so that the product is a perfect square. First question, 6561. I will take two examples, okay? From this question, I will take only two questions. Remaining all you have to do, okay, students? Now see, the question is, which number should be multiplied? First, we have to find whether this number is a perfect square or not. If it is perfect, don't do anything. If it is not perfect, we have to make it perfect. Okay? And for making perfect, we have to multiply it by some number and we have to find which number it will be. Okay, students? Now understand this one. So start answer. Answer for this is 6561. We are finding the squares, whether it is a square or not, by prime factorization method, okay? I think that you remembered, okay? Now first we have to take, see, on the ones place, 0 is there, or 2 is there, or 4, 6, 8, among these, any number is there? No, so it is not, this number is not divisible by 2. If a number having a 0, 2, 4 at unit place, that number is divisible by 2. But this is not divisible by 2. So we have to take another number. After 2, which number is there? 3. We have to take a number here which are prime. Okay, don't take other number. Now 3. We have to divide this. 3, 2 is a 6. Simple division is there, okay? 3, 2 is a 6. Now in the table of 3, 5 is there? No. But less than that number, which number is there? 3, 1 is a 3. Now, there is 2 remaining because we have taken 3, 1 is a 3. So 2 will be there. Now it will become, yes, 26. But in the table of 3, 26 is there? No. Less than that number? 24. And on which number? 3 is a 24. Now again 2 remain because it is 26 and we have taken only 24. Now it will become, last number will become 21. Now in the table of 3, 21 is there? Yes. 3 7 is a 21. Now see, this number is again not divisible by 2. So we can't take here 2. Now take after that, this number is there? 3. Again 3. Now see, this is 21 in the table of 3. 21 is there. 3 sevens are 21. Now after that, 8. 8 is in the table of 3? No. But less than that number? 6. 3 twos are 6. Now from these 6, from 8, 6 is we are taken. Here will remain 2. Now it will become 27. Now in the table of 3, 27 is there. 3, 9 is 27. Okay, students. Now see, 7, 29. It is again divisible by 2? No. It is not divisible by, it is not divisible by 2. So we have to take 3. Now, 3, in the table of 3, on which number it will come? Which number 7 is there? No, but less than that number, which number? 3, 2, 6. Now 1 is remain. Now next number will become 12. 3, 4, 12. And the last number is 9. So it is in the table 3, 3, 9. Now this number is again divisible by 3. So take 3. This is 24. 3 is 24. 3, 1, 3. Now see, this number is again divisible by 3 because it is not divisible by 2. 3, 2, 6. 2 will remain here. It will become 21. 3, 7, 21. Now take again 3 because it is 27 and in the table of 3, 27 is there. 3, 9, 27. Now see, this number is again divisible by 3. We have to continue our process till 1 not came. Okay? Now 3, 3 is 1. Now take one more time 3. Because 3, 1 is 3. Now see, 1 is there. So stop the process. Now we have to take this number in the product of these. So 6, 5, 6, 1 can be written. How many times 3? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So take 8 times 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now we have to make pair. If all numbers are having pair, then it is a perfect square. If there is no pair, then that number is not perfect. This is first pair, second pair, third pair and fourth pair. That means all numbers are in pair. So this number is a perfect square. So we don't have to multiply this number by any other number. Okay. Now I am taking one more example. The example which is of not perfect square. Okay. The number which is not perfect. Let us take one example. 4851. Second, 4851. Now we have to check whether this number is perfect or not. Similar method we have to use there also. Okay students, first we have to take the number like 4851, prime factorization. This number is divisible by 2? No, because here is 1. So we have to take this number after 2, 3 is there. Now we have to check it is divisible by 3 or not. See, 3, 1 is 3. Here is 1 remain. Now it will become 18. In the table of 3, 18 is there. At which number? 3, 6 is 18. Now this is 5. In the table of 3, 5 is there. No, but less than that number? 3 itself. 3, 1 is 3. Now here 2 remain. Last number will become 21. In the table of 3, 21 is there. At which number? 7 number. Yes. Now see, this number is again divisible by 3. So take 3. 3, 5 is 15. 1 is remaining here. Now it will become 11. In the table of 3, 11 is there. No, but less than that number. Yes, which number? 3, 3 is 9. Now take. Here will 2 remain, it will become 27. 3, 9 is 27. Now we have to check whether this number is divisible by 3 or not. If we take 3, now see what will happen, okay? If we take 3, what happened? 3, 1 is 3, 2 will be remaining. 3, 7 is 21, 2 remaining. But last number will become 29 and in the table of number should be divisible by 3. So this number is not divisible by 3. We have to take next another number. Which number, students? After 3, which prime number is there? 5. So this number is not divisible by 5 because on unit place 0 should be there or 5 should be there. If any other number, that means 1, 2, 3, 4, then 6, 7, 8, 9. If their numbers are in this place, that number is not divisible by 5. So after 5, which number is a prime number? After 5, 7 is there. Now we will check whether this number is divisible by 7 or not. In the table of 7, 53 is there? No. Less than that number, which number is there? 7, 7 is 49. Now, 53 minus 49, how much remain? 4. Now it will become 49. So, 7, 7 is 49. Now, see, this number is again divisible by 7. 7, 1 is 7, 7, 1 is 7. Now it will become 11 and it is not divisible by any number because it is a prime number. So we have to take 11. 11 ones are 11. Now see here, 1 is there. So stop the process. So 4851 can be written as multiplication of these numbers. 3, 2 times. 7, 2 times. 11, one time. Now we have to make pair. Pair means there should be two numbers or two digits. This is first pair, this is second pair. Now see, one number is remained but it is not having a pair. It is not having pair means this number is not perfect. Understand this thing? If there is a pair for 11, that means if there is one more time 11, that time we can say this number is perfect. But here is only one 11, that so it is not perfect. We have to make it perfect. For making it perfect, we want a pair for 11. That means we want one more time 11. So if we multiply this original number by 11, we will get pair for the divisor, prime divisors of 4851. That means after multiplying it by 11, it will become a new number. Okay? Now we have to multiply 4851 by 11. It will become a new number and that new number is a perfect square. Okay students, this is not perfect square, but after multiplying it with 11, you will get a new number. That new number is nothing but a perfect square. Now understand? Now your doubts are clear. We don't have to multiply because the question is only for check for perfect or not, or we have to multiply that number by which number. Okay, according to questions we have to just find this is perfect or not. So first answer is over and we have to find by which number it should be multiplied. So write that only the number. Okay, don't take the multiplication of that number with this, don't take this way. Okay, only we have to write this, not perfect. And which number is only one time, that we have to write. That means 11 is only one time. So we have to multiply our original number by 11. If we are multiplying that number by 11, the new number is perfect square. Okay, students, understand this one? If your doubts are clear, say yes in comment box. Understand till this? Now similar question, but that question is for division. Question number 10. Question number 10 is check. I am just writing which number. number we have to replace. Check whether the following number are perfect square. If not, find the smallest number by which this should be divided, not multiplied. Okay, divided. So that the product is a perfect square. Now we will take the next example. Now the next example is 432. Okay. 432. Same procedure we have to follow. Write your number, then prime factors, whether they are having a pair or not. If any number is extra, that means here the question is for multiplication. Okay, we are multiplying, but at the time of division, we have to cut this number. Cut this means you have to divide that number. Which number is extra? That is the difference between the first question number 9 and this question number 10. Now understand? Question is 432. Now see, at unit place 2 is there, so it is divisible by 2. Start with 2. 2 2's are 4, 2 1's are 2. 1 will be remain here, 2 6 are 12. Now 6 is there, so it is again divisible by 2. 2 1's are 2. Here is 1, which is smaller than this, so we have to take 0. Now it will become 16. 2 8's are 16. Now take one more time 2, because this is 8 and it is divisible by 2. 2 5's are 10, 2 4's are 8. Now again divisible by 2. 2 2's are 4, 1 time 2 7's are 14. Now see, this number is not divisible by 2. It is divisible by 3. 3 9's are 27. Now this is again divisible by 3. 3 3's are 9. Now again 3. 3 1's are 3. So stop the process because 1 is there. Now we have to take the number in product form, because our number is 4, 3, 2 is 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 times 2. 1, 2, 3, 4. Multiply. 3 how many times? 3 times. Now we have to make a pair. Okay, till then, be safe at home.